ओके मैम, यू कैन स्टार्ट.
नमस्कार,
यस मैम, यू कैन स्टार्ट.
गुड इवनिंग ऑल. आई डॉक्टर पूजा बिकरा, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ जम्मू कॉलेज ऑफ फिजियोथेरेपी एंड ओनर ऑफ द फिजियोथेरेपी क्लिनिक. थैंक्स टू द माइज एकेडमी गिविंग अपॉर्चुनिटी टू मी एज अ रिसोर्स पर्सन अ क्लास ऑफ वेबिनार ऑन अ न्यूरो रिहैबिलिटेशन इन पेडियाट्रिक्स. Now move to the topic, neuro rehabilitation in pediatrics. I'm audible? Hello?
Yes ma'am,
Hello.
You're audible,
okay.
You're audible.
Okay. Now the objective of the neuro rehabilitation is neuro rehabilitation, goals of rehabilitation, principle of rehabilitation, now rehabilitation. What is neuro rehabilitation? Neuro rehabilitation is a complex medical process which aims to aid recovery from nervous system to minimize or compensate any functional alteration resulting from it. That means any kind of the injury occur in the brain, whether it's a traumatic or pathological cause that leads to the damage of the brain tissue. And our rehabilitation helps the patient to recover this thing. In neuro rehabilitation, there should be a neuro rehabilitation team. Medical team, neurologists, neurosurgeons, psychiatrists, pediatrics, physiotherapists, occupational therapists, recreational therapists, prosthetists, orthotists. Principle of the neuro rehabilitation begins during the initial contact of the patient. Now the patient in the hospital or acute stage or subacute stage, when approach your patient, rehabilitation should be start during the first day when the patient has the injury. Restoring the patient to independence or to regain its maximum pre-illness. Maximize the independence within the limits of the disability. As much as possible, try to independent the patient within the limits of the disability. This is necessary because some disability are not totally recovered.
Hello ma'am, you're not audible. Hello? Hello? I think ma'am got disconnected, so we'll wait. Kindly wait, ma'am will rejoin. Yes, ma'am, you are audible.
Hello. My network problem.
Okay. No issue, ma'am.
Now move to the neuro rehabilitation. First of we all know about the neuroplasticity. It's a little bit away from this topic, but it is necessary to aware of this term. Just only review for few lines this topic. Neuroplasticity. The word itself. Shows neuro means neuron and plasticity means to mold. That means the potential of the brain to react and adaptive changes based on the outside and inward food. Flexible property of brain to change temporarily or permanent. Adapt to the new stimulus everyday life, it helps the strengthening of the new weak connection after the brain injury. In neuroplasticity, the major role of the cortex. Our cortex has a capacity to develop plasticity after the brain tissue injury. Now, neuroplasticity, as I earlier told, remember, brain neural network map is not hardwired. It's a plastic. That means recoil, reorganize itself. How it itself? I'm taking the one example for this. For example, here is my clinic. Sorry, here is my house and here is my clinic. Every day I am follow this pathway to reach here, from here to here. One day I am find this road, there is a huge traffic. Now I decided to choose another pathway. Now move to from here to here or from here to here. Whether it's short pathway or whether it's a long pathway depends upon the your capability. How to one day you might be okay, this is a very difficult for me, huge risk, because it's our habitual to follow the one path regularly. Like this, our brain tissue recovers like this. How is occur? Our brain, there is a axon, everyone knows, axon structure, dendrites, nuclei, synaptic poles, there should be a, and there is a neuromuscular junction. Neuromuscular junction has played a major role in our neuroplasticity. There is a two term is important in the plasticity, potentiate and depression. What is potentiate? Potentiate, everyone know there is a presynaptic, postsynaptic, between there is a synaptic cleft. From one presynaptic to postsynaptic, there is a huge organelle transfer here. Now, chemical mediator that bind with receptors, then pass to the postsynaptic and work. In this example, potentiate. Potentiate means there is a electric potential. When you do the activity, there is a routine electrical potential generated in presynaptic. Okay, then huge amount of the bombarding here. Okay, then it transmit to the postsynaptic via a synaptic cleft. Then it helps to regain the brain tissue to recover earlier, and it helps to the positive response. It's a synaptic changes. Now we have to find about structural changes. In this, we have to like playing the piano. In early stage, we don't know how to play the piano, or during the very early stage, no one know how to play the toys, or no one know how to ride the bag. Once you use, then you know. Like that, our structural integrity also change. Like once you use the activity routine, repetitive task, this will help to you. Okay, if you are, there is a less electric potential in presynaptic, then that means there is less bombardment in occur in the postsynaptic, that it helps to decrease the response, but it shows a negative effect on the structural in daily ideals. So we have to find maximally to potentiate the patient as much as possible, because our rehabilitation focus to earlier recover the patient. But you have to notice every person varies response one activity to another activity. You are doing the one exercise today, another one week, you have to change the exercise, you have to focus, this exercise might be not working for this response. So focus on the this two term in when you're doing the exercise. Now, Bobak, now move to the approaches or rehabilitation. Bobak or neurodevelopmental technique. It was developed by Kiran Bobak and Bhatta Bobak in 1940s. And it is focused on improved motor control, patients who have damage or deficit in the CNS. Function is demonstrated when the patient exhibits normal posture, movement pattern when performing a task. Dysfunction occurs when a patient exhibits abnormal posture and movement pattern. In this, what If you are seeing any activity, then also necessary to do the functional task. If you see any dysfunction, then also necessary to do any functional task. That means in this clinic, task is more important. Focus on the motor behavior and neurosciences of that time when the Bhatta Babas discovered this technique. Trent entity is based on movement therapy or theories that focuses on the development and learning of the skill. An interactive system model, the esthetic body system interacts with the esthetic sectors of the physical and social environment. The therapist uses specific and precise handling of the patient to promote normal posture and movement. It should be theory based on the, or entity based upon the motor control and motor relearning theory. It itself is a huge topic. I am just giving the idea. Motor control theory says there is two things more important in the motor control theory: reflex theory and hierarchy theory. Reflex theory says reflex itself generates a stimuli that helps. That means the stimuli should be a sensory, whether it's external or internal, and it will help to involuntary movement of the body. And Babas said this will help in the our rehabilitation if reflex generates in the body, whether it's external or internal stimuli. Another thing about hierarchy theory. Hierarchy theory is means itself voice suggests it should be a manner wise or the sequence wise. Everyone know higher center control the lower center. Highest in cortical or midbrain or lower level is cortex brain stem midbrain. Cortex is functioning the coordination, and midbrain over is more focuses on the primitive reflexes or gross motors. Our pons medulla, these all think in the physiologically work like respiration and all these things. This should be important when you doing the NDT. In this technique, the important point is you do anything, but you most focus on the proximal part of the body or proximal key point. Because like if I am generating the this limb movement time, then what will I do? First, not initiate the this movement. We will focus on the proximal part. If base is stronger, then it will help from this thing. So it depends upon task to task. Which task you have to need in the rehabilitation, then focus on this. So the facilitation of the proximal stability with normal posture and movement pattern, the patient is able to perform differently appropriate task. In this image, child can be ready for the crawling stage. So in this, a booster can be used. Child should be placed on the booster and giving stimuli to knee joint, okay, and holding the scapula to grasp further this booster to generate the stimuli point as a proximally. Now in this also doing this thing and gaining the confidence or playing with this thing toys, it will help to execution of the task which help in the baby. In this image, trunk stability can be achieved. Next pose is Bernstrom approach, mainly used in the adults, but some influences on the children. Use permissive reflexes and a synergy movement pattern were evoked reflexly to develop some tone in the muscles later on the violation movement were trained. Encourage whatever the movement is possible and building on it. So centering, sensory stimulus, positive reinforcement.
Hello, ma'am. Ma'am, if you can hear me, you are not audible to us.
But maybe some network issues. Let's wait for a few minutes.
Ma'am has got disconnected, so kindly wait.
Sorry, it's network.
Okay,
problem.
Ma'am is back.
Network problem.
No issues, ma'am, no issues. You can continue from where you left.
It's okay, sir? Are you seeing?
Yes, yes.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, patients are taught to voluntary movement is available to them achieve goal. Movement will be progress in the correct sequence. Abnormal movement will always come first, followed by the injury. And there is a normal pattern of the recovery before normal pattern of the movement are obtained. Now, thing is what? I have told them things. You have to use the permissive reflexes. Okay? Synergy movement. That means permissive reflexes what? Present during the birth time. And synergy movement is what? Group of the muscle work flexibly. Okay, you have to see in spastic child or any spastic condition, whether it's adults or whether it's child, you should be focused to develop synergy, a correct synergy pattern. First of all, you should work on the flexor stage to develop a control spasticity. Okay, because if you are not treat, then patient is also develop a spasticity, but that kind of spasticity is not required for the our treatment. That's why it's necessary to start the treatment during the very early stage or subacute stage. Now here I am showing according to the Bernstrom, how the treatment comes. During, for example, brain tissue is damaged, first stage is flaccid. That means there is no movement, no tone. This is a normal man and this is the abnormal man or abnormal child. In this, after injury, there should be a muscle atrophy. It not necessary, injury can also lead to the muscle atrophy, like cerebral palsy, okay? There should be also muscle atrophy. It's a non-progressive disorder. There is a various myths about the cerebral palsy, but this is not about this presentation, sorry. Now, another is here, after the stage one is over, flexibility is come, then you need to facilitate in this stage. Due to that means this stage you have to work mainly a positioning. You should maintain position in bed during activity, child will crawling, child will rolling, or whatever the thing you have to, child can do. Okay. Now next stage, this stage second. In this stage, there should be a typical synergy pattern, whether it should be like a flexor synergy pattern or extensor synergy pattern, or sometimes there should be a typical static pose developed. In this phase, spasticity will begin. Okay. Now, but voluntary movement is possible, whether you give the treatment or not give the treatment. But if you need a good amount of the voluntary treatment, you should focus on the acute rehabilitation as much as possible. That is not means you are not working in the chronic when the patient comes, but it takes more time. Now, stage three, you should maintain the all position. Spasticity can be decreased. If you are working here, good amount, here spasticity should be decreased as you have working good amount. Now, when the stage three is over, stage four come. Here, little bit associated movement can be done, patient. Next, stage four. In this stage, patient can be achieved in little bit voluntarily, little complex movement, like you have to give a rattle, take a rattle from here to here, or give time, they show the interest or activate these things. Now, in this stage, child can do little bit complex, like he is playing with different objects and also walking, catching something, all these things. Now, in the next stage, he is able not 100%, but as much as the disability of the child, he is able to little independent as much as possible. Now, roots approach. In this approach, it's based upon the motor control theory and developed by the Margaret Root in 1950. developed a system of therapeutic exercises enhanced by the cutaneous stimulation for the patient with neuromuscular dysfunction. Proprioceptive maneuvers such as positioning, joint compression, joint distraction, approximation, uses of reflex, fetch, resistance, mainly proprioceptor can be activated in this, like brushing, stroking, icing, cold, warm, pressure on various tendon, bone, dissolving. Now there should be one thing. This root support said there is a facilitation as well as the inhibition technique. Facilitate itself is to facilitate the thing. Inhibit, rokna. Us cheez ko rokna. Jo hume extra cheez wahan pe mil rahi hai, jo hamare kaam ki nahi hai, hume us cheez ko us limit pe hi rokna hai, taki wo hamari jo rehabilitation hai, usko hamper na kare. I have wait. I am describing some model. Can I move the laptop?
I think ma'am got disconnected. Let's wait.
Hello. Hello.
Yes, hello, ma'am.
Hello. Are you listening?
Yes, ma'am. We can hear you.
Ma'am.
Hello.
Yes, ma'am. We can hear you.
Okay. I am describing the model. Root approach. I don't know where I am. The
sound is not audible, ma'am.
There should be a holding this to fine. I am not mute myself. Are you audible?
Yes, ma'am. You're audible. Hello? Yes, ma'am. You're audible.
Okay. Ma'am, it is not audible, ma'am.
Ma'am, you are speaking quite softly. Can you speak a little louder if that's okay with you?
It is audible.
Okay, I'm trying. Okay. Can you see the model?
No, ma'am. Hello? We can't see. I think you should stop the sharing of the screen. Yes, ma'am. Now visible.
Oh, sorry. Again, I have.
Yes, ma'am. Here. It's visible.
It's visible. Let's see.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, I am here showing you roots approach. Roots approach itself, that there is a different technique, inhibition as well as facilitation. Now, we have you use inhibition technique like touch. This is also a cutaneous. You have to give a touch, little pressure touch, okay? Because less than 2 is enough to this child. If greater than adult, like this, okay? This will help in child to create the cutaneous stimulation and their feedback to the proprioceptor to activate, okay? And the one more thing is, you should all, whether facilitation technique or inhibition technique, any technique, you should focus on the dermatome level. Many of the clinics, these things can be doing wrong because they are not focusing on the dermatome level. Because one day we can't achieve all the body these things. Okay? You should focus on the many on the dermatome level. Every dermatome level has a muscle innervation. So it's major thing focus on. Like another technique, brush. Roots use the brush. Soft touch brush. Okay, if you use hard, it lead to the facilitation. Spasticity will facilitate. Okay, like this. Like if you are using deltoid, then you have to follow the deltoid dermatome level. If you use the this one C5 or C6 or sorry C8 types. You can follow this like this. Okay. Now another thing. Inhibition technique for the taping. I'm listening. Hello.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. This is a KT tape. Okay, I have already cut this thing. I have this. The wall might be some of them not seeing this. Just like this. Okay. This is a KT tape. I'm just showing, not doing all the things. You just tear the three compartments. And remember, this should be always a corner should be a round because it pulls at the side, then leads to the away from the your side. Now, if you have to see a child's hand should be like a this. That means it's a flexion process. So you have to extend the this finger or anywhere you have to doing the treatment. Okay. Now you will tear this thing, stretch now around this, okay, face. Place little pressure, now stretch, the thing is stretch, okay. Now stretch this thing, after that, remove the disc. Okay. Now do not pressure in the center. End. Pressure at the end. Now then in the middle. Okay. I'm just showing you. Okay. Like this. All fingers you should apply this. And after that, when you apply all the this thing, like this. This is the wrong method I am doing, but due to the network problem, so I am doing fast this thing. You should place the anchor here. Here should be you place the anchor, okay? Now at the terminal end, you should be place the anchor, okay? Understand this thing? This is the taping. And why you doing, you think no one thing, this taping technique, if you are doing the facility phase, that means you are doing the facilitating taping, okay? Like what, because our hand is no movement, no voluntary movement is there, you want to movement. So you have to use the facilitatory technique. In this technique, you have to use the origin to insertion tape, but I have used the insertion to origin tape because I am inhibit these things. Okay, for facilitation use origin to insertion, for inhibition using from insertion to origin. Okay, this is mainly for the facilitating and root approach. You should also use this thing, joint compression. How, if you are doing the this one shoulder. Now how? You just compression. Okay? This is the compression. Go little bit near. Joint go to the little bit near. And compression, okay? Every joint, okay? If you are doing the this one, approximation, hold here, then do the this thing. Okay? Little bit away from the joint. Now move to another thing. Proprioceptive facilitation technique. I'm listening. Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Hermann Kabat developed PNF technique in 1940s. Further developed Dorsey, Voss and Margaret Knott. It's very important technique whether you are doing this technique in adults or in pediatric population. It helps to restore the normal movement mainly. Okay. Now, to restore the normal movement, focus on your developing sequence of the movement. Agonist, antagonist muscles work together to produce a coalesced movement. Focus on the mass pattern of the movement that are diagonal and resemble functional movement. the body does not work in parts, but instead as a whole. Primarily, PNF technique focuses on the three things. Increase the motor learning on the agonist to the repetitive of the activity or repeated contraction, rhythmic initiation. These are the different techniques used in the PNF. Reverse the motor pattern of the agonist, slow reversal and rhythmic stabilization, both of which used as an isometric contraction. Finally, learn to relax muscle, help to increase the motion and decrease the opacity. Here, lower limb, D1 flexion pattern showing. Here, trunk stability pattern showing. This I am showing this one pattern you also. Are you seeing the couch?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Later. If children should be engaged some activity, remember this thing, or coordinate with mother or parents while doing the any rehabilitation, because sometimes children get angry without the parents. While you're doing this technique, you would proper receptive neurofacilitation. Itself would suggest we have to initiate the proper receptive sensation in joints. Okay. And neuromuscular, that means nerves and muscle, facilitation to move on. Now, for example, I have shown one pattern, D flexion, pattern on the upper limb, okay? Now, here is the hand movement, shoulder little bit abduction, internally rotated, and elbow is extended, pronated arm, now little flex, okay? Little flex. Now, you have to remember, this technique first always initiate with the cube stretch. If you are not giving the cube stretch, then proper acceptance take a time to initiate. Cube stretch, after that, you have to give the command to the patient to move on this limb. How? Aap apni is par jo ko sir ke upar leke jaoge mere saath, okay? Now, upar leke jao, like this, okay? I am saying this is the only pattern, not any technique. Now, like that. Now, ask the patient, niche leke ho, like this. Okay. During the very early stage, patient is not doing any movement, but this pattern performing always with the technique. Okay. Like one technique is the hold relax. Okay. When the little achieve the voluntary movement patient, then ask the patient, chalo upar uthao, now yahan roke rakho. Okay, this is called the hold relax. Chalo upar leke jao, roko. Here should be you gave the stress, then ask the patient, apni ungliyon ko khol ke, niche aao, shabas, ruko yahan. Nicho, like this, okay? This is the hold relax. Now, another technique is the repeated contraction. During this pattern or whatever the lower limb or trunk pattern or any pattern, you have to use the every technique with pattern, okay? Now, another is rhythmic initiation. Ask the patient, first upar uthao. Jaise hi wo upar uthayega, little, your response is little. Contribution of the patient when achieve the voluntary effort, okay? This should be remembered during the early stage, patient is not contributed any. You should maintain the pattern all the limb, okay? Now, upar leke jo, shabash. Now, pull up your limb ko pura. Ab ye hai ki ye child agar chota hoga, to aap usko bologe nahi, kyunki wo samjhega nahi. तो आपको ये पैसिवली खुद करना है विद कोऑपरेट विद अनदर टेक्निक्स माइट बी अगर ये फ्लैसिड हुआ तो हाथ को ओपन करना पहले जरूरी है पहले तुम कंपार्टमेंट में वर्क करोगे आफ्टर दैट यू हैव टू फैसिलिटेट द दिस पैटर्न लाइक दिस हम लोग क्या करते हैं क्लिनिकली हम लोग बस पैटर्न में फोकस करते हैं बट चाइल्ड शुड बी स्पेशली चिल्ड्रन देयर शुड बी रेस्पिरेटरी प्रॉब्लम दे ऑल्सो डिले द रिहेबिलिटेशन You also use the little bit I'm showing the for respiration PNF pattern like this one. Which child should be relaxed as much as possible. Then place your hand, both the hands on the sternum. Now take both the hand club each other. Now then press down and toward the caudal pressure little. Okay. During inspiration, when the child inspires. Now then relax. 5 to 6 contraction is enough for the children. Like that, you will.
I think we're having a network issue.
Here is the connection network problem.
No issue, ma'am. No issue.
Okay. Now move to the conduction education or conductive education. Combined educational and task-oriented approach for the children. Child is educated how to use his or her abilities, performing active movements, and generalize this learning to different life situations. Child presents activities in the form of the group using music. Rhythmic speech during activity. Paying attention to all aspects of child development, the physical, intellectual, cognitive, social approach is important. Educational program for parents can also improve the quality of the children. The approach is said conductive education. That means this approach is necessary for the education. Education is not restricted to the studies. Education is a various type, like this child has a little education. Some have the more sharp-minded, then grasp these things. But engage these child in the different group activities. Some, that means interest of the child shouldn't be matter in this, and it helps to develop the cognitive function, interact with the different person. जिनको उनके जैसे मतलब सेम बीमारी होती है उनसे इंटरेक्ट होता है उसको देख के वो मोटिवेट हो सकते हैं अलग अलग डिफरेंट काइंड का उनको म्यूजिक सुनाओ वो उनको एक्टिवेट कर सकता है म्यूजिक थेरेपी इज आल्सो वेरी हेल्पफुल इन द चिल्ड्रन वो थेरेपी डायनेमिक न्यूरोमस्कुलर ट्रीटमेंट मेथड बेस्ड ऑन द डेवलपमेंटल काइनेसोलॉजिकल एंड प्रिंसिपल ऑफ द रिफ्लेक्स लोकोमोशन वॉकिंग पैटर्न अ लाइट प्रेशर ऑन सर्टेन स्टिमुलस जोन दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट फॉर दिस थेरेपी यू शुड फोकस ऑन द स्टिमुलस zone like muscles and bones. Resistance to the current movement is caused the involuntary motor response. Reflex locomotion is activated from three main positions, prone, spine and sideline. What the therapy said, here are the three major positions you have to use in this therapy, prone, spine and sideline. This is the stimulus, variant stimulus point. In prone position, this is acromion process where you have to place the pressure. Like here is the femur, epicondyle, calcaneum, ASIS, mid scapula. Like this, there are different points. You have to place the pressure and resistance also. one side you have to pressure, another side you have to resist. You also cooperate with the some another therapist support. There is also inside line and supine line. There are different zone of the pressure. There should be two things in this important. There is the reflex gripping and reflex rolling. Reflex gripping is the movement sequence that include the most fundamental components. Pacific, postural control, upright or extension against gravity, goal-directed tapping movement of the arm and leg. Okay. I have only told this pressure point. Here, you see the this picture. Here, there should be a pressure. Okay. Now, patient, here is also pressure. Here is the one therapist to turn the child. Here, this also pressure. Here, child is another therapist. Try to turn the child like this is also here. One is the pressure zone, another is the stimulus zone. When you are the giving the resistance, this is the external stimuli to the child, then move to the next position. Now, reflex rolling. That means transition from side, supine to sideline and crawling. Therapeutically, reflex rolling is used in different spaces of spine and sideline. Here, also pressure should be placed. First is what? Supine position. In this, resistance, that means stimulus should be given and child turns to the sideline here. Okay. Then when the child achieves the sideline, then next position is what? To focus on the crawling. Like first is prone, then crawling. Okay. Here is the stimulus and here is the child can be moved. Sensory integration training. Based upon the idea, then some child experience sensory overload and oversensitive to certain type of the stimulus. When children have sensory overload, their brain has trouble processing or filtering many sensations at once. Meanwhile, other children are undersensitive to some kind of the stimuli. Expose children to the sensory stimuli is a structured, repetitive manner. Over the time, brain will adapt and allow them to process and react to sensation as more efficiently. Treatment focuses on the integration of the neurological process by facilitating the individual to the type, quality and intensity. That means child should be placed a sensory stimuli in different sensory situations. In this, trunk stability is achieved, but child should be integrated in the different, here should be a cone as the child to put this hole in one place to the another. Here there should be a lightning ball. Here should be a sling to focus on the trunk stability. Child move to catch this thing. Hydrotherapy, one of the good therapy for the children. Immersion in the water can enhance the treatment of neurological impairment individually with both therapeutically, psychological and social benefits. Hydrotherapy is a term used for exercise, warming water and popular treatment for patients with neurological and musculoskeletal conditions. The goal of this therapy are muscle relaxation, improve joint motion and reduce pain. Here I am showing video. Due to the buoyancy force, it helps the child. This is a parallel bar fits in the swimming pool. Hypotherapy. Traditional time, this is very useful therapy. Now it is also encouraged in the clinic, but different ways, not putting the horse in clinic. Rehabilitation strategy performed with a moving house, which has demonstrated its potential to improve the mobility of the children with cerebral palsy, especially cerebral palsy ke liye use kiya jata tha. In this training, low frequency, high repetitive treatment strategy can be used to improve motor functioning and quality of the movement in children. Horseback riding improves the flexibility, posture, balance and mobility of the rider. Muscle contraction and postural adjustment are required to react to the horse movement. 30-minute session of horse walking at a speed of 100 steps per minute will induce the 3000 steps. To maintain the vertical alignment and weight to these postural changes, the child must encourage their trunk stability, different kind of the muscles. During the session, the child takes various positions, forward sitting, side bending, backward bending. The therapist and the trained side walker provide support and movement possibility for the child sitting on the horse. Like this, child sitting on the horse. In this image, the child placed on the horse. It helps to reduce the adductor tightness of the lower limb, or many another muscles also help to reduce the adductor tightness, trunk stability. The wonderful thing for this therapy is it helps to initiation of the feet while doing this thing. What can be walk a little distance, child encouraged to do the movement. Like this, in this maze, facilitate the walking. It also helps in the to improve the cognitive function. In clinic, we have to use like this. This is a wooden, and in this there are different types of spring. The state-induced movement therapy. Kindly speak, this is less important in the children. It's also studies in the upper limb. One study of the body has impairment in movement or sensation, which may cause difficulty with daily activities, specially used to improve upper limb function. Characterized by the following element, least training, the unaffected side, concentrated and intensive practice over 2 to 3 treatments week for 6 to 7 days with the unaffected hand. We spend 90% of the walking for following 10 days of a 6 for intensive program and shaping activity. It helps to increase the efficiency of active program involved selected tasks, then they systematically increase in difficulty. This is often referred to as the shaping process. CMT improves the movement efficiency, performance, and precise use of the involved limb. That means your unaffected hand should be a constraint. That means उसको बांधा जा सकता है, ठीक है? After that, उसको हम 30% जब भी हम use करते हैं during the treatment, जो सही वाला हाथ है, उसको हम use करते हैं activities के लिए. देखा गया है कि इसका जो influence है वो कॉर्टेक्स पे पड़ता है, जिससे क्या एसोसिएटेड जो न्यूरॉन्स हैं वो स्टिमुलेट जनरेट करते हैं और जो हमारी अफेक्टेड एक्टिविटी है उसमें जो है वो हमें मदद करते हैं. See the baby how to do the movement. This is a constrained hand. Motor relearning program focuses on the practices of the missing task components, whole task, and transfer of the learning. Example of use of the real world environment, forces of the use of affected upper limb, increase the activity of the upper limb muscles, stretching, uses of the key muscles of the upper limb. In this, there is a 4-step should be involved. First, whenever the child or patient come to you, you have to see, analyze the task. Other example, उसको हमें बोलना है कि आप ये करो या आप सीधा चलो. Child को कुछ भी बोलते हो तो आप उसकी पहले activity को note करोगे. उस activity में देखोगे कि क्या missing है. जो हमें पूरी movement देखने के बाद you have to find the missing component of that task. उस task को लेके हम उस पे जो है वो काम करेंगे. Practice the task repeatedly. Then the achieve the task, after that transferring of the learning in different activities, which this helps the child to develop the neuroplasticity. Like this, here this is the hemiplegic hand or spastic hand, and here grinding should be taken with another hand, and therapist try to resistance this had, don't move here and there, so that focuses on this hand, it helps to generate the activity in the this hand. Like this different, like this in this task, you have to place your arm in table. You should focus on the protection, retraction, all the things of the shoulder, elbow, hand movements, all. By manual training, focus on the improve the coordination based on motor relearning, learning theories, practice specificity, type of the practice and feedback. But it should be based upon the hand-arm bimanual intensive therapy. It, in this technique, also focuses on the neuroplasticity, both the decreased time and progressively increase the postural changes represent the main difference from the hand-arm bilateral movement. 30% of the time is devoted to areas where the standing or walking is required, like dressing, brushing, doing one hair, combing, transporting object here to there. Remaining 25% spent in the gross motor activities, bowling, playing, jumping, hockey, use of Wi-Fi, bi-fix balance board, or there should be a ball. Here there should be a child perform the two things, listening the command of your therapist and also tucking the chain. That means there is a two things is working. One is the cognitive function, another is the coordination. Virtual reality, use of interactive stimulation created with computer to perform user in virtual environment that appears sound, feel similar to real world objects with events. Dynamic nature of the stimuli increase the ability of the cognitive or motor demands. The use of standard desktop or laptop, camera based video captures, gestures, other sensory devices can be used for this. In this, we are using the camera based device, different kind of the how the child use the hello.
Yes ma'am, you're audible.
Okay. Now next is the treadmill training, or the combination of the treadmill training and technology. A typical form of the gait training has been performed on ground with assistive device or parallel gait. Treadmill has recently gained ever more attention as an instrument for gait training and assessment with several advantages or conventional methods. Reduce physical demand, establish a convenient setup for gait evaluation to improve balance, building strength of the lower limb. Partial body weight treadmill training is used. There are the different kind of the treadmill used. This is a recent treadmill underwater treatment. Here initially give the proprioceptor with the help of the proprioceptor sensing will the help of the therapist. Once the child learn the movement, then independently he or she can do. Robot assisted therapy is conducted using robotic device that enable the patient to perform specific limits movement, allow the patient to achieve a large amount of the movement in a limited time. To motivate the child to perform his or her therapy through the playful games such as cars, races, to perform exercise with mimic aerials. Allow the patient to receive visual, auditory or sensory feedback. Enhance the neuroplasticity by and enabling the patient to initiate and accomplish movement activity as possible. The strength of the robot-assisted training is based on the repeated, goal-oriented, cognitive tasks which appear to the particular interested in the pediatric age. It helps to develop the neuroplasticity, which helps increase the strength and improve the isolated movement. Hair screen can be used to biofeedback. How the goal attainment therapy. Therapy itself names the death task centered to facilitate the child participation in everyday life situation. Example, to communicate parents, siblings, peers, to move from one place to another, to dress or undress, eat, play, based on the motor sensory theory. I have already told to you this. Developmental and learning of new skills occur in interaction between the child, task to be performed, and particular environment in which the activity takes place. Goal should be a smart, specific, measurable attainment, relevant, and time. Functional training and practice of functional tasks are important part of the rehabilitation. Effective listening and communication are strategies and fundamental component of the successful intervention to establish a goal. In this, there are the different kind of the task-oriented techniques can be used, like single task, dual task. Like when the child is gain the function or voluntary control, engage the child, like playing with another children, cycling with another children. It helps to develop the neuroplasticity and helps to regain the functional tone in the muscles. Strengthening training program. Once the child achieves the voluntary access, then it's necessary to program the strengthening training. Muscle weakness is the primary impairment. You have to use the isokinetic device. There is a lot of the kinetic device using nowadays. Task-oriented weight-bearing strength training for children was effective in increasing the strength, functional problems. Strengthening exercises include functional closed kinetic chain. Like this, in this image, leg press up can be used a child to develop the strength in the leg. Here cycling can be used, here trunk stability for the trunk achievement of the trunk strength. Here is also a leg press up can be used. Here is also balance and postural or gait control training. Normal balance achieved involves the system, vestibular, visual, somatosensory. These system collaboratively work to maintain the equilibrium as well as the posture and help to maintain the walking. Environment should be a structure and task created in both open, closed and closed situation. Closed task is what? Those tasks which do not change from one trial to the next. Matlab aapne jis task environment mein bhi kiya, next time bhi aap usi mein karoge. Open is you require to change the environment. Not necessarily per day, it might be a weekly or the monthly, because to deviate the attention of the child and it helps to maintain the environment. Like this, here single leg achieve. If child is not achieve itself, then therapist can help. Here dome can be used to train the balance. Here wooden log and in this over there is a plate and place the child to maintain the this child enjoy the to and fro movement. Different kind of the instruments can be used. Now the most and major thing is the family sentence models or counseling. How the healthcare professional interacts and involves children, family in the care. Successful parent and therapist collaboration is characterized by the following therapist competencies: ability to listen, share, and learn with families. Ability to foster the parental role and expertise, ability
We are having some connective issue. Ma'am will join in few minutes with.
Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. These are the huge topic. Itself is a large topic. I am just giving a few lines about this. Biofeedback is work on the our equilibrium system as well as visual feedback, sensory stimulus. These all can collaboratively work. And another trick is the mirror training. There are the different kind of the mirror. Sorry, network is again going. Hello.
Yes, ma'am. You're audible.
Okay. Now I'm talking about the little bit there's some modalities. Nowadays, functional electrical stimulation. Difference between electrical muscle stimulation and functional electrical muscle stimulation. Electrical stimulation only doing in the inside the clinic or in couches also. Functional electrical stimulation doing with the activity, engaged with the activity. And research is going on still. Transcranial direct nerve stimulation, it was very effective because the previous stimulation was used in the periphery. Okay, peripheral stimulation gave to the brain. But the transcranial direct nerve stimulation gave direct to the cortical stimuli. And the electrode placement, it should be like this thing, EEG. Now, somebody might be thinking this is very dangerous for the stimulation, but it in this there is a galvanic current can be used. It I think less than 2 milliampere current can be used. This helps to the regaining the neuroplasticity earlier. Different electrical stimulation, different strains can be used. Transcranial direct nerve stimulation, here electrode should be placed. There should be anode and cathode. Electrode placement should be equal to the EEG. Mirror therapy engaged in front of this is a mirror and child doing the activity pegboard. Here is the biofeedback. This is the reference. Thank you. Now take a home message. Start thinking wellness, not illness. Thanks to my academy. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. It is